It is with deep regret that we received the news of our member, field captain's mother, Jalu, set her sad demise on the morning of 17th of March 2017 in Kuala Lumpur. It is indeed sad, and that's the reason why I'm up here on the stage. As she would have been with us today, right now, to celebrate Nowruz with us here, with Phil and May. They intended to come down on the 17th of March to Singapore, the very day, that was the very day that she was called to the Creator, our Mazdar. From the eulogy that Phil sent to me, she had even packed her own bag with the selected clothes for this evening's function. She was an incredible woman with a strong will and positive attitude towards life. She was just so independent, even at the age of 94, that she never bothered anyone to take care of her. She even celebrated recently the Besna ceremony for her granddaughter in Ashoy in Mumbai. She spent most of her early life in Mumbai, where she was born, but moved to US, where Phil had already settled for many years from his young days. She moved to US with her daughter Rita and her son Rehan. This was a major change in her life, but undeterred, she adapted to the new life very quickly and traveled on her own in and out of US many times without fear, despite her own medical problems. Besides Phil, she had two other sons. She had a very jovial and cheerful personality and made friends with ease, who in return adored her for her courage, determination, self-confidence and zest for life. She remained mobile and mentally alert and bright till her last breath. Pilo and I came to know her for past several years, and only a few months ago, while she was in Singapore with Phil and May, we had a lunch together. She was so courageous and determined to be independent and mobile that she had no hesitation to have her knees replaced in US despite her advanced age. Even though she had medical problems, she brushed them off as minor and shuttled between US, Mumbai and Kuala Lumpur, often completely alone on her own. Phil has been a filial son and looked after her with all the affection and love which she richly deserved to cherish. Her sudden demise will leave a vacuum in Phil's and his sister Rita's life, and the pain and grief of this separation will take a long time to heal. Although she is not with us here today, as it was planned earlier, we feel her spirit is with us, and we pray that our Mazdar rest her soul in eternal peace. The greatest blessing that he bestowed on her was he did not let her suffer, and for all her goodness, took her back peacefully in his arms. I would request everybody to stand up and maybe have 1 minute of silence.